this lecture, we will see how to design 2-bit synchronous up counter using JK flip-flop or T flip-flop, and also we will see 2-bit synchronous down counter also. Now in the previous lecture, we have seen some introduction to the synchronous counters, that is how to design, what are the steps to follow to design this synchronous counter, and we have seen one design, that is 2-bit synchronous up counter using D flip-flop. Now in this lecture, we will see using JK flip-flop as well as the T flip-flop, and also you will see some down counter using one of the flip-flop, right? So this is the 2-bit synchronous up counter using JK flip-flop. Now what is the step one? So step one is we have to choose how many number of flip-flops required. So the moment we set 2-bit synchronous up counter, so it will do the number of counts, total number of counts will be 2^n, so capital N will be 4. Now how many number of flip-flops required? So this n is equal to 2, so these are the number of flip-flops required, right? So here we have chosen JK flip-flop. Next, what is the step 2? So step 2 is we have to draw the state diagram, right? State diagram. So we need up counting. So state diagram means it will start from 00, then it will goes to 01, then 10, then 11, and it will come back to 00 again. So this is the state diagram. Now what is the third step? Step 3 is, so we have to choose the flip-flop, right? So which type of flip-flop we are going to use? So already we have chosen JK flip-flop, so JK flip-flop. Now we have to know what is the excitation table of this JK flip-flop. So first we will draw the JK flip-flop excitation, then we will draw the truth table. So if it is going from 00 to 01, what is the inputs we need to give for this JK flip-flop, right? So what is the excitation table means? So what is the present state and what is the next state? So it is going from present state to next state, what is the excitation we have to give? That is JK. So two inputs means how many combinations? Four combinations: 00 to 0, 0 to 1, 1 to 0, 1 to 1, right? Now if you recall, when we discussed about this excitation table, all the flip-flops, I have given some easy way to remember. So SR flip-flop, JK flip-flop, D flip-flop, as well as the T flip-flop. So 0 1 2 don't cares, and we have to write opposite way, 0 1 don't cares. But anyway, we'll see from the functional table how. See, if I want 0 to 0, that is it is following the as the previous state only. So we'll get two conditions, that is, so when I give 0 0, so it will be previous state only. But when I want 0, that is a reset, so this is also possible. So 0 1, so this is J, this is K. When I give 0 0, if you see the functional table, so it will follow the previous state. When I give 0 1, that is a K as 1, so it will reset the output, so it is also gives as 0. So I'll get two conditions. See, this is fixed, but this is varying, so I can have 0 don't care. So 0 don't care. Now 0 to 1. So 0 to 1 means it is complementing. So I can give 1 1. So it will become Qn complement. If I give 1 0, right? So if J is 1, that is set. So output is also will be set. So this is 1, and but this is varying. So 1 don't care. Similarly 1 to 0, so 1 to 0, again it is complementing, so Qn bar, but I need 0 also, so it will be 0 1 also, because we know when K is 1, so output will be 0. So what is this? This will be don't care 1, so don't care 1. Last one, 1 to 1, see, no change. So 0 0, 1 condition, 1 means 1 0, so 0, this is for don't care. Now see, we can easily remember 0 1 2 don't cares, and write opposite way, 0 1 2 don't cares. So once we know the excitation table, the fourth step is we have to draw the truth table and find the minimal expressions, right? So that we'll see like this. So present state, next state, so two outputs, so q1 q0, this is also q1 q0. So how many flip-flops? We need two flip-flops. So J1 K1 J0 K0, right? So this is required excitations, required excitations or required inputs we can have any name. Then so we can give here clock. Now we'll see. See, initially it will be 00. So what is the next state? It should be 021, because from the state diagram, so 00 to 01. So that will happen when we apply clock. It may be positive edge, it may be negative edge. Next, when I apply clock 2, this will be as a present state. So next state will be 10. When I apply clock 3, present state will be 10, next state will be 11. When I apply clock 4, present state will be 11, next state will be 00. So it will count the 4 clocks. So what is this count, this name of the counter also we can give, either 2-bit synchronous up counter or mod 4 synchronous counter, etc. Now we have to use the excitation table to get the required inputs or required excitation. So just see Q1 to Q1, so 0 to 0. So what is the 0 to 0? Simply 0, don't care. So 0, don't care. Next, 0 to 1. So what is the 0 to 1? 1, don't care. Next, 1 to 1. See, 1 to 1 is don't care, 0. Next, 1 to 0, don't care, 1. See, 1 to 0, don't care, 1. So this Q1 to Q1 is over. Next, Q0 to Q0. So 0 to 1. So what is 0 to 1? 1, don't care. Next, 1 to 0. So what is 1 to 0? Don't care, 1. Next, 0 to 1. So 0 to 1. 1, don't care. Next, last, 1 to 0. So what is the 1 to 0 again? Don't care, 0. So don't care, 1. See, 1 to 0 means 1 to 0. Don't care, 1. So this is the required excitations. Now what we need to do? We have to get the minimal expression for J1, K1, J0, K0. That is using KMAP. So for J1, so draw the KMAP, two variable KMAP. Inputs will be Q1, Q0, 01, 01. So 01, 2 don't care. So 01, 2 don't care. Now, how many combinations I can make? So only I have to use 1 and don't care. So if you combine this, I will get extra term. So J1 will be simply, see, what is this? Q0, right? So simply Q0. Next, K1. Now Q1 Q0 01 01, see, 2 don't cares, 01, 2 don't cares, 01. Now again I can make combination like this. So K1 also will be Q0 only. Next, J0. See, if you see that J0 and K0 all are there, right? 1 don't care, 1 don't care, don't care, 1 don't care, 1. So no need to use the KMAP. I can make simply J0 is equal to 1, K0 is equal to 1. Why? Because if you use the KMAP also, 1 don't care, 1 don't care, 01 01, Q1 Q0. So I can make the what you call quad directly, right? All are ones. So all are ones means J0 is equal to 1, K0 is also 1, because K0 is also don't care, 1 don't care, 1. So no need to use the KMAP. For if you see any 3-bit, 4-bit, anyone, so if you see the J0, K0 always will be, there is no 0. Always either 1 or don't care will be there. You can verify any 3-bit or 4-bit. You can verify this. All will be 1 or don't cares. If it is a full counter, that is, if it is a 2-bit mod 4 counter, or it should count all the states. If it is a 3-bit, it should count all the 8 states. If it is a 4-bit, all it should count all the 16 states. If you are stopping in between, it may change. That also we'll see. So once we know the what you call the minimal expressions, so last step is, so this is the step 4, right? So what is the last step? Step 5 is draw the logic diagram. Now we know J0 is equal to K0 is equal to 1, J1 is equal to K1 is equal to Q0. Now what is the clock we need to use? That is our wish. So we are using, suppose clock is negative edge triggering, because we are not connecting this clock to the previous state output to the next clock, etc. So we are applying the same clock, so we can use either negative edge or positive edge, no problem at all. Now how many flip-flops required? 2 flip-flops required. I have done 2 flip-flops. So see, remember, I can use MSB here, LSB here, there is no doubt at all. So if I use this J0, K0 here, So what is J0, K0? Simply I have to give as 1. So J1 and K1. So what is J1, K1? J1 is equal to K1 is equal to Q0. So this is Q0, Q0 bar, Q1, Q1 bar. So directly it is going here and this is also coming here. Now clock. So negative edge I am using, same clock I have to apply here also. That's it. So this is Q1, this is Q0. So this is the logic diagram, this is the clock. Right now, have you seen what is this procedure? See, we are going for 5 steps. If you see, or if you compare with the asynchronous counter, so we don't require any of this procedure. The moment it is a 2-bit, so we will draw the simple 2 flip-flops and we will connect this Q0 as the next flip-flop clock. That's it. And J1, J0 all will be 1, because always it will complement the outputs, right? So that is the reason the synchronous counter is design is somewhat tedious. So we have to follow these steps, we have to draw the truth table, excitation table, etc. Right? But this is the fastest counter. Yes or no? See, we are applying the same clock to all the flip-flops. So the moment clock is changed, it will change the state. So what is the maximum propagation delay in this synchronous counter will be simply 1 flip-flop delay. This is the propagation delay of 1 flip-flop. So 1 flip-flop propagation delay is enough to change from one state to another state, because the same 2 flip-flops are working simultaneously. But if you see from the asynchronous counter, so this will wait for this output. Yes or no? And this propagation delay as well as this propagation delay will accumulate. So the propagation delay is 2 times of TPD, but here only 1 propagation delay is enough to change from any state to any state. Right? That is some advantage. That is, if you want some advantage, so we have to do some extra work. Yes or no? So that is what we are doing in synchronous counters. Now we can verify the functionality. Right? Now, so this is a negative edge. Suppose clock 1. So this is a negative edge. So clock 1 means first both will be 0, 0. The moment, so this is the present state, next state. This is Q1, Q0. Now clock 1, so 0, 0. Right? See, okay, both are 0, 0. The moment we apply clock, what will happen? See, J0, K0 is 1. So what happens when J and K is given as 1? It will toggle the output. So Q0 is 0, but it will become to 1 because J0, K0 is 1. Now, so J1, K1 is given as 0. Yes or no? So 0 is given here, so it will maintain this previous state only. So it is also 0. So 0, 0 to 0, 1. So when we apply one more clock, which is negative edge, so what will happen? Now, what is the present state now? Q0 is changed to 1, but Q1 is already 0. Now if I apply one more clock, what will happen? So this Q0 will change its state again. So 1 to 0. Now see, the moment we apply clock, the clock is going for same, all flip-flops. Now, previously it was 1, so it is taking some time to change 1 to 0. So in that case, so the input of this J1 and K1 is 1 only. Yes or no? So what will happen when J1 and K1 is 1? It will toggle the output. So this is the present state. Now it is becoming 1, 0. Yes or no? Because both flip-flops are working simultaneously. So it will take the previous state, not the this is 1 to 0, it is changing, right? But it will take as 1 only, because to change from 1 to 0 it is taking 1 propagation delay. So for that moment it will take this 1 as the input only. So this is also changed to 1. Now if I apply one more clock, which is negative edge trigger, clock 3. So what is the present state? 1, 0. Now same clock. Now what is the present state? So anyway, J0, K0 is 1, 1, so it will change its state. So 0 to 1 it is changed, but 0 is the input of this change. So 0, 0 means what? This is 1. So 0, 0 for J1 and K1. So it will maintain the previous state. What is the previous state? 1 only. So it will be 1. So again, it will maintain the 1 only. Right? Because both are working simultaneously. Remember. Next, the last one, clock 4. what the present state? 1 1. Now J naught always, I mean this flip flop always change its state, so it will change 1 to 0. But 1 1 is the input of this J1 and K1, so it will also toggle the flip flop, so our output, so it will be 0. So 0 0, that's it. So 0 0 to come back to 0 0 again, right? So that is that one. See, if I want to change from 0 1 to 1 0, I'm taking only one propagation delay of flip flop. 1 0 to 1 1, same one propagation delay. Here also one propagation delay, here also one propagation delay. But if you see asynchronous counter, so from 0 to 1 or 1 to 0, both outputs are changing. So here I need twice of the propagation delay, right? So that is the advantage in synchronous counters, right? So it's very fast, right? Only one propagation delay is enough to change from any state to any state, or any sequence to any sequence, right? So next we'll see the same counter but using T flip-flop. So the first three steps will be same, that is number of flip-flops required is 2, and the state diagram 0 0 to 0 1 1 0 1 1 and come back to 0 0 again. Then step 3 is we have chosen T flip-flop, and what is the excitation table, so we have to draw. Now first if you remember the excitation directly, very good, otherwise first draw the truth table or function table. Whenever we give 0, it will follow the previous state. Whenever we give 1, it will complement the previous state. Now I need 0 to 0, so any change, no, so that means I have to give 0. So 0 to 1, there is a toggling, so I have to give T input as 1. 1 to 0, again it is toggling, so I have to give 1. 1 to 1, no change, so simply give as 0, right? So this is the excitation table. Now what is the next step? So draw the truth table and find the minimal expression for T1 and T0. So I need two flip-flops, so T1 and T0. So this is the present state to next state. I have drawn already, so 4 clocks. So see only Q1 to Q1. So 0 to 0, any change? No. So I have to give as 0. So 0 to 1, there is a change, so give as 1. 1 to 1, no change, give as 0. 1 to 0, there is a toggling, so give as 1. Next, Q0 to Q0. So 0 to 1, there is a toggling, give as 1. 1 to 0, toggling, give as 1. 0 to 1, toggling, 1, give as 1. 1 to 0, toggling. Now simple, T0 I have to give always 1. But what is a T1? If you see, if you observe carefully, 0 1 0 1 0 1 0 1. So T1 is simply following Q0. That is, you can verify from this note table. Remember, don't take next state as the inputs, take present state as the input. So 0 0 I'm getting 0. 0 1 I'm getting as 1. 1 0 I'm getting as 0. 1 1 I'm getting as 1. See, it is following only Q0. So I can directly write here, because no need to go for the K map, because this is a T flip flop, so I'm getting only 4 outputs, right? So 0 1 0 1. So you can easily correlate what is happening. Now so next, what is the logic diagram we have to draw? So two flip flops I can draw like this. So this is T0, T1, Q0, and this is clock. Now I'm using the positive edge trigger flip flop. Okay, you can use negative edge also, no problem at all, but so there should be some difference, that's why I'm taking positive edge. Now what is T1? T1 is following the Q0. What is T0? Always given as 1. So this is Q1. So this is flip flop 0, you can give flip flop 1 and so on. So this is the outputs Q1, Q0. That's it. So you can verify the functionality also. So always it is changing its state, but this will change depending on the Q0 output, right? Input we are making, or we are giving as a input, not the clock, right? So a very simple design. Now we'll see how to design 2-bit synchronous down counter. So it should do the down counting. So what is the first step? Always number of flip-flops. How many required? 2-bit means 2. So what is the maximum count we'll get? 4. Now when we draw the state diagram, so we have to draw opposite way as we have done in the previous case. That is, if it is initial state is 0 0, so it should go to 1 1, 1 1 to 1 0, 1 0 to 0 1, and it should come back to 0 again. So this is 0, this is 3, this is 2, this is 1. So it is going like this, right? Or we can say descending order, right? Now the third step is, so what is the flip flop we have to use? Or so I'm using here JK flip flop. You can go for D flip flop as well as the T flip flop. So that you can take as no assignment for you, so you do on your own. Now So once we choose in this JK flip-flop, we need excitation table. If you remember, directly you can write, that is 0, 1, 2, don't care, 0, 1, 2, don't care. So opposite way you can write. If you are not, if you don't remember, so what you do is draw the functional table. So depending on that, you can get this excitation table. Now, what is the fourth step? We have to draw the truth table and we have to get the minimal expressions. So that is the fourth step. So present state, next state. So initially it is 00, and when we apply clock, the next state is 11. Next 11 will be present state. If I apply clock, so then the next state will be 10. Again, 10 will be present state. If I apply 1 clock, the next state will be 01. Similarly, when your 01 is there, when I apply one more clock, so I will get 00. So it will be go back to 00 again. So how many counts it is doing? 4 counts. So it is counting the 4 clock pulses. Now when I want this state change from 00 to 11, what is the inputs we have to apply at the J1, K1 as well as J0, K0. So that is important. So see first 0 to Q1 to Q1. So 0 to 1. So 0 to 1 it is changing. So what is the inputs required? 0 to 1 means 1 don't care. So 1 don't care. Next 1 to 1. So 1 to 1 means don't care 0. So don't care 0. Next 1 to 0. So 1 to 0 again don't care 1. Next 0 to 0. So 0 to 0 means 0 don't care. So this is Q1 is over. Next Q0. So 0 to 1. So 0 to 1 is 1 don't care. Next 1 to 0. So don't care 1. 0 to 1. So 0 to 1 means the first one only. So 1 don't care. Next 1 to 0. So 1 to 0 in second one. So don't care 1. Again, if you see J0, K0, and it is a full modulus counter. So J0, K0 always will be 1. So from this directly I can tell J0 is equal to K0 is equal to 1 only. So we have to go for this J1 and K1. Right? So if I draw this, so you can easily verify also it will follow the Q0 bar, I think. So Q1, Q0, 01, 01. So 1 don't care. 1 don't care. Don't care 0. Right? Now here you will get one problem. If you are using like this, if you are making like this, it will become Q1 bar. If you are making like this, you will get Q0 bar. Right? So that is our wish. So I can go for Q1 bar or Q0 bar. That is, if you are making combination something like this, I will get Q0 bar. If I am making like this, I will get Q1 bar. Next, K1. So what is the K1? Don't care, 0, 1, don't care. So this is 0, 1, 0, 1, Q1, Q0. So here also, if you are making like this, I will get K1 as Q0 bar. So if you are using the Q0 bar, so go for only Q0 bar. So if I make the combination something like this, the K1 will become as simply Q1, right? So if you are using Q1 bar, go for Q1. If you are using Q0 bar, go for Q0 bar only, right? Now what is the last step? So we have to draw the logic diagram. So two flip-flops. So if you are using a positive edge trigger, so go for like this. If you are using a negative edge trigger, so give us simple bubble. So this is clock. So this is J0, K0, Q0. Q0 bar, J1, K1, Q1, Q1 bar. Now, what is J0 always? J0 and K0 always 1. Now, what is J1, K1? So, J1, K1, if you are using Q0 bar, very good. So, take it like this. Give it to same as the J1 and K1. If you are using this one, Q1 bar and this Q1, you have to give like this. See, this Q1 bar will come like this and Q1 is come like this. Right? So, like a feedback. Right? So that is our wish, whatever we want. But the functionality should be verified, right? So you can verify the functionality by this diagram, so you can get the same sequence. If you are drawn like this, that is Q1 bar and Q1, verify the functionality, right? Now we'll verify the functionality. Will we get this sequence or not? We'll see. The moment we apply clock 1, so present state will be 0, 0. So the present state will be 0, 0. Now when we apply clock 1, so positive edge, then J0 and K0 is always 1, so it will toggle the output. So Q0 is becoming as 1. So 0 is changed to 1. But initially 0. So what is a Q0 bar? It is 1. So it is also 1, 1. So that is the J1 and K1, That is, this flip-flop also toggles the output because the inputs are 1-1. So Q1 also will change it to 1 only because both flip-flops are working simultaneously. That means it will take the previous state, right? Or we can say present state. Then it will change it to the next state. That is 0 to 1. Here also 0 to 1, right? Next, the present state will be 1-1. When we apply clock 2, so what will happen? We'll see. So this flip-flops always toggles the output. So it will change it to 1 to 0, right? But what is the present state? 1. That means this is 1, so this will be 0. So when I apply 0-0 for this JK flip-flop, it will maintain the previous state. So what is the previous state? 1. That means it will be 1 only, but this fellow will change it to 0, right? So this is maintaining 1 and this is changing to 0. Next, when I apply clock 3, what is the present state? 1-0. Now, so see, the Q0 is 0, but what happens to Q0 bar 1? Now this is 1-1 is here and 1-1 is here. So both will toggles the output. So this will become 0, this will become 1. Yes or no? Then when I apply clock 4, so this is 0, this is 1. Next. So Q0 always toggles the output because J0, K0 is 1. So it will change it to 0. So present state of Q0 is 1. So what is Q0 bar? Q0 bar is 0. Yes or no? So 0 means will it change its state? No. It will maintain the previous state only. So that means it will maintain the 0. That's it. So it is following the same sequence what we want. Right? So we can verify this functionality when we apply this one. J1 as Q1 bar and K1 as Q1 also. That you verify. If you are getting a wrong sequence, please post a comment. Right? So this is about the 2-bit synchronous up counter as well as the down counter.